chap, kick his feet up a little bit. He's, you know, been working hard throughout the course of the evening. David, we got the microphone there, but first of all, we're about an hour, you know, removed from the fight. How are you feeling? Main eventing here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena against Caleb Plant, a massive victory. What kind of statement do you think you said and you made here this evening?
I just felt really great. You know, I just want to give the thanks to the fans who came and made this filled up the arena. I feel like we did exactly what the fight lived up to, what it was supposed to live up to. It's bad blood, but I'm glad that me and Caleb Plant were able to fight like warriors in the ring and, you know, bury the beef, basically. But I knew I was stronger than him, and I knew I had a lot to prove. I had a lot to show to the fans. A lot of people said I didn't have defense. I just come forward. Yeah, I do come forward, but I have a lot of defense. I have a lot of tricks on my sleeve, too. And I think I showed it that I'm a monster. You know, after the sixth round picked up, I just started picking up and, you know, started, you know, landing some big shots, like countering the body shots. As soon as I got the engine going, and it was just no turning back. And, you know, like I said, I love this. I have one of the best fighting spirits in the game, and I just love going toe-to-toe with anybody.
Well, we love watching throughout the course of the 12 rounds. Questions for David Benavidez. We'll start off over here with Keith Iden.
David, congratulations, man.
Thank you.
You said before the fight that you would not be satisfied if you did not stop him. Was it at all not satisfying because you didn't get the stoppage?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a little disappointed I didn't get the stoppage, but if you, you know, you guys seen how his face looked. You know, he was really bloody, and I was really imposing my will. I really beat him up really good, and like I said, I'm not really satisfied because I didn't get the knockout, but this is a great way to get a victory, you know, just dominating performance. It was a great performance. There's a lot of things I can tweak in my game to make sure I get the stoppage next time, but also I feel like, I don't want to throw Kenny Bayless under the bus, but, you know, he didn't call Caleb Plant out in any of the clinches he was doing the whole fight, you know. I mean, I think if Kenny Bayless would have said something about the clinches, you know, maybe he would have stopped Caleb from trying to clinch, and I would have clipped him. But I was hurting him a lot of times, you know, busted his eye open, hurt him to the body, and, you know, I can still get better, but I am satisfied with his performance. I'm not gonna say I'm not, but I'm very satisfied.
And last question for you is, your dad said the other day, if he were Eddie Reynoso, he wouldn't put Canelo anywhere near you. You feel the same way that it's going to unfold like that? That he's not going to fight you, or do you think he eventually will?
I mean, I feel like as Canelo Alvarez, he needs these fights. You know, a big fighter like me, this is definitely a really big fight. You know, as you can see, as me and Caleb Plant was a huge fight. You know, so I think it'd be a huge pay per view numbers. And I mean, let's just take it back to fighting, man. I mean, I want to prove myself. Canelo's proved himself, but I feel like he needs to give me the opportunity too. And it's not like I'm begging for something. I've been mandatory for the past two fights. So it's something I've earned, you know, and especially after this fight, I show that I belong to being, I deserve being there. You know, I wasn't really getting hit as much. You know, I mean, my defense was good. I thought Caleb Plant was faster, so I was really countering, and I was using my head movement and defense good. I know I can get better, but I feel like the only fight that people want to see in super middleweight is me versus Canelo, so let's give it to him.
Let's get it! Questions
for David Benavidez.
David, en español, el resto maduro de López Cuervo, aquí a tu derecha. Acá, David, aquí, mira. David, antes que nada, creo que la gente piensa que es muy fácil noquear arriba del cuadrilátero, y yo creo que no hay nada que reclamarte, absolutamente nada de tu actuación, pero quisiera hacerte dos preguntas. La primera, ¿no crees que fue sumamente valiente Caleb Plant y merece un reconocimiento?
Sí, pues es un peleador muy bueno, se está moviendo mucho, pero yo creo que la razón que no lo quiere es porque Kenny Bayless no le estaba diciendo nada cuando me estaba agarrando bastante toda la pelea. So, yo creo que por eso no lo quiere, pero él es un guerrero también, es un peleador muy bueno, so, no, le tengo mucho respeto por él.
Well, you know, I didn't knock him out because Kenny Bayless didn't allow me to, really. People think that knocking people out may be easy, but it's not. And I still feel like Plant was a warrior, I really respect him. And, you know, I won rightfully the way that I could, you know.
Y finalmente, David, haciendo un análisis de tú, de David Benavidez, ¿te sientes listo ya para que la siguiente pelea sea con Canelo Álvarez? Haciendo un análisis tú mismo de tu actuación, si la siguiente para ti es Canelo.
Sí, pues ahorita yo me siento 100% listo para Canelo. Yo creo que hay muchas cosas que puedo arreglar en el gimnasio y eso es lo que voy a hacer. Me voy a tomar unas vacaciones, 3 semanas de descanso y pues vamos a comenzar a trabajar otra vez. Pero yo creo que sí, estamos listos para Canelo en septiembre. Yo creo que él me tiene que dar la chance para pelearlo y estamos listos, los fans están listos, yo estoy listo y hay que darle la pelea.
The question was, do you feel ready for Canelo now that you're kind of planned? David said that he's 100% ready. I'm 100% ready. I'm gonna take a quick vacation for 3 weeks, then it's time to come back to the gym, tweak some things, and then let's give the fans and everybody what they want.
Yeah, we all want that fight. I especially. Can you imagine? More questions for the media.
Over here. David, congratulations to you and the family. You don't really get tested like this in fights too often, I guess. Where did you kind of find it inside, you know, to kind of turn things around when they needed to happen, and then, you know, what kind of changed the fight for you? Did it feel to you like your power would overcome him at some point?
Yeah, I mean, the main thing is that I wanted to be patient. I mean, Caleb Plant is a great counterpuncher. As you can see, he's really fast. I didn't want to just go in there and get countered with any, you know, shots. You know, I really had to take my time. I think you guys seen a good jab. My jab was way more effective than Caleb Plant's. You guys are only talking about Caleb Plant having the more better jab and stuff like that. But as soon as I got in there, you know, the fight is not a 4 or 6 round fight. It's a 12 round fight, you know, so you got to start slow. But as soon as I, you know, I found my groove, there's nothing you can do to stop me. You know, I hurt him to the body, hurt him to the head, cut the ring off pretty good. And like I said, I'm just satisfied with this. There's a lot of things I can fix in my game, but overall, I'm satisfied with this. This is my first fight pay-per-view. This is the biggest fight I've ever been in. It's the biggest fight of my life. And I feel like I did amazing. You know, I mean, we went out there. I told you I'm going to put a beat on Caleb Plant. So that's what I did.
Quick question right here, David, in front. After seeing your stablemate Ryo lose the way he did on those judges' scorecards, after that bout in the 12th round, after it rang, did you guys have any thoughts or like second guess that maybe the judges would go against you guys?
That's a good question. I wasn't thinking of that at all. I mean, I was just a little disappointed because I thought Ryo was more effective. You know, he rocked him a lot. That was his fight. You know, I had to fight. He fought his game. You know, I had to fight my game plan. You know, I couldn't think if the judge were gonna rob it. You know, so I just had to keep fighting my game plan, stay disciplined, stay focused, and you know, that's exactly what I did.
David, right here, brother. Steve Cordeno, KOR Sports. Congratulations, man. Talk to me about the end of the fight. The bell rings. You raise your hand. You're kind of walking around the ring, and Caleb comes up to you, kind of puts his arm around you, you guys exchange words. Talk to me about that moment there.
I just told him, you know, man to man, sorry for all the trash talk that we went at each other. You know, we talked a lot of shit to each other, and a lot of it, I'm not going to say it wasn't necessary, because it was necessary, because this fight was huge. You know, it's a huge fight, and sometimes that's what you need to bring the best out of two men. And we're both warriors. He's a warrior. You know, he definitely showed it, but I showed it that I'm the better warrior. And I wanted this opportunity to be challenged by a top super middleweight. You know, he's definitely top 30. You know, I'm top 2, the number 1 is Canelo. So, I mean, we both had a lot to fight for. You know, the winner supposedly is going to be Canelo. And, you know, so I put everything into this training camp. You know what I mean? And I know he did too, but, you know, at the end of the day, I don't want to hold no grudges against nobody. I'll only do that in case, unless we're, you know, we're building a fight or something, but after that, there's no need, you know. I'm not that type of guy. I've never been that type of guy, so I have nothing to respect for Caleb Plant, and, you know, I'm happy he gets to go home to his family safe.
Congrats, man.
Congratulations. This question for Samson. It's a while ago, but you called the chances of fighting Canelo a fantasy fight. I was wondering if you thought those chances had changed. Did they change tonight? What do you think about that? About the Canelo possibility?
Well, I thought that it would never happen. Now I believe it could happen. And the reason is because you have nobody else to fight.
Yes.
You have anyone of a quality of opposition
that he deserved a letter. So I believe that he would understand and he would take the chance to fight the Mexican monster.
Hey, David, congratulations. Most people watched the fight and had the fight on even terms or maybe had planned ahead, you know, the first half of the fight. Was there a particular instance or a flurry, a punch that you felt the fight being turned in your favor?
Yeah, I don't know if you guys seen it, but I hit him with a body shot and I go, ugh, and that's all I heard you. And that's what changed everything. That was in round four. And from there, it was just kept hitting him with body shots, kept hitting him with hard shots. I know I'm the harder puncher. That's why I'm told you guys. I've said it over and over again. Everybody I've been in the ring with, I've hurt everybody since I was 14 years old. And that's something that nobody can take away from me. I know I got that power, you know, and if somebody pushes me to the limit like that, I get even stronger. So, yeah, that was basically when it turned, and I just kept hurting him. I was really surprised because I don't know if it's just the neck workouts we've been doing, or I don't know what it is. I don't feel the power with these guys at all. And I didn't feel the power with Caleb Plant. I thought it was going to be way faster. I guess I just, you know, I worked on my head movement really good. But I knew I didn't really feel threatened at all. I don't know. It was just a good fight. I was just in it 100%. I'm just happy to be in these type of fights because I really love this. I really love fighting. I love going toe to toe.
Well, David, the night belongs to you, so we'll give you final thoughts as you conclude. Still the WBC interim super middleweight champion of the world, remaining undefeated, main eventing here, a raucous crowd, passionate people watching all over the world. Your final thoughts as you get ready to enjoy a nice vacation with your lovely family?
I'm just happy, man. I'm happy that I can give these type of fights to the people. I mean, the people really enjoy this type of fights. And like I said, I'm willing to put my body on the line to make sure the fans get these type of fights because I'm, at the end of the day, I don't care about belts or none of that. I feel like I'm a world champion because the fans make me feel like that. And I'll put myself on the line for anybody just so you guys can join these type of fights. And thank you so much. I'm really appreciative and grateful for everything.
Ladies and gentlemen, still undefeated.